Steve Whiteside here with this week's edition of Gold Stock Trends for Friday, October 29th, 2010. Now, I'm a little late to producing this video this morning, so the markets have actually opened. The TSX has opened higher, gold's up a couple of dollars in the early trading on Friday morning. Now, it's been a volatile week for gold and gold stocks, and we came into the week on a sell signal. On Thursday, we had a nice big move up, took us back up to just under the upper channel line. A close above that line, a close above 1344.19 on Friday would give us a buy signal. Gold was up when the markets opened this morning, so if we can close above 1344.19, we've got a new daily buy signal. Now, the pros were getting pretty close to giving up control on the gold market, and with Thursday's turnaround, we would expect the pros to stay in control of this market and help move the market higher, at least up to retest the most recent high. Now, a lot of people are watching the U.S. dollar, hoping that a lower U.S. dollar will be supportive of higher gold prices. And right now, we're looking for a close below 77.0650 to give us a new sell signal for the U.S. dollar. Looking at the XAU, we've had a little pullback here. It didn't even come down to the peaks that we saw in the summer. I was looking for a much lower target. We didn't get there. On a short-term basis, looking at 10-day market breadth, we were oversold and now we're coming back. Looking at the XAU itself, we need a close just above 202.38 on Friday to give us a buy signal. I don't expect a lot out of any rally from here. You're going to see a couple of stocks that really had nice moves up yesterday, but I'm looking for the overall index to just get back to the recent high. There's still a lot of resistance up here. The pros did give up control on the stocks. They're now back in control as of Thursday's close. Looking at Barrick, we need a close on Friday above 47.25 to give us a buy signal. Big up day for Agnico Eagle on Thursday. We're now on a buy signal once again. We need a close below 70.19 to give us a sell signal on Friday. Looking at Anglo Gold, we're looking for a close above 46.66 on Friday to give us a buy signal. For Yamana, we need a close above 11.08. For Coeur d'Alene, we're looking for a close above 20.31. For Freeport, we're looking for a close below 94.05 to give us a sell signal on Friday. For Goldfields, we're looking for a close above 15.58. Now, Goldcorp had a big up day on Thursday. We're now back on a buy signal. We need a close below 42.32 on Friday to give us a sell signal. Looking at Randgold, we need a close above 98.13. For Harmony, we're looking for a close above 11.35 to give us a buy signal. For Kinross, we're looking for a close above 18.32. For Newmont, we're looking for a close above 61.10 to give us a buy signal on Friday. For Pan American Silver, we're looking for a close below 31.01 to give us a sell signal. For Royal Gold, we're looking for a close above 49.25. For Silver Wheaton, we're looking for a close below 26.27 to give us a sell signal. And for Silver Standard, we're looking for a close below 22.68. Silver stocks are still holding up very well. Now, the stock that I'm personally trading, and it trades on the Canadian and U.S. markets, is Eldorado. Looking at the U.S. market, we need a close above 17.64 to give us a buy signal. And in the Canadian market, I'm currently short this stock and looking for a reason to cover those shorts. And on Friday, a close above 17.92 for Eldorado would give me a new buy signal, cause me to close out the remainder of my shorts and to go long this stock on a close above 17.92 on Friday. Okay, that's all for this week's edition of Gold Stock Trends. For those of you who watch our daily videos, I'll be away on Monday. I'm away for the weekend, and I'll be back on Tuesday morning. So the next time you'll hear from me is on Tuesday morning. So have a great day, have a great weekend, and we'll talk to you next week.